Welcome back to this series on tightness. If you haven't watched the first video, I recommend you start there. Okay, here we go. One thing we know about how to get better at something is to practice it, to repeat it. We know that we need to do lots of repetitions in order to solidify our skill. The problem is that this is happening all the time in our movement without our conscious awareness. What I mean is, most of us are practicing tightness. One thing that must be grasped here is that tightness is learned. You didn't start tight. And if tightness is something that can be learned, then you can learn to undo it, or you can learn a new way of being in your body. You can establish a new relationship with your body. Now, when I use the word learned here, I'm not referring to conscious learning. You wouldn't consciously learn how to be tight. That'd be pretty dumb. What we are discussing is subconscious learning, a learning that happens underneath the surface. You have learned to be stiff by not using your full ranges of motion. You have learned to keep tension in your body. You have learned to close your body. It is referred to as learning because you repeated it and you got a lot better at it. But unfortunately, the repetition of such things led to a tight body. Let's go deeper by making a distinction between stiffness and tension. Stiffness is a physical limitation. It's when you try to touch your toes, but you're stopped by your hamstrings and your calves. Or you try to reach above your head and your arms stop 3/4 of the way up. There is a palpable something stopping you from going any further. This often feels like a stretch, a blockage, a pinch, a weakness, or many other sensations. Stiffness is related to what we do or don't do with our bodies, what we practice. If you never stretch your hamstrings or you never bend over to lengthen them, then it's likely that your hamstrings are going to be stiff. Most people in the modern world today spend most of the day sitting. That means that the quads and hip flexors are in a shortened position. If these folks get into a quad or a hip flexor stretch, it's likely to feel like a monstrous stretch. This tightness comes from the repetition, the practicing of sitting, where the quads and hip flexors are shortened all day. You see, movement is all of the time. Practice is all of the time. It doesn't matter that you punched your clock to work out and then you punched out. Your body is adapting every second of the day. Another way to understand stiffness and perhaps going a level deeper is getting into patterns of movement. As you develop in life, you engage in activities that favor one side or the other, such as throwing a baseball or jumping off one leg in track or basketball. Or it could be as simple as feeling stronger in one side. So every time you sit down, you put all of your weight in that leg. It's literally everywhere and everything. And as you get older, you repeat these patterns more and more, and you practice them more and more. These patterns can lead to certain muscles being really tight, strong, or weak, which can even lead to bones being shifted into different places. This is called an imbalance. So we often target stiffness by stretching or strengthening in order to allow muscles to let go and strengthen the right places to pull us back into balance. So overall, stiffness occurs because you never enter certain ranges of motion, or you have patterns that are pulling you out of balance. Okay, now tension. Tension is a little harder for us to conceive of. Tension is a holding of ourselves. It's a stress response or an emotional response. It lies under the surface, going unnoticed until you tune into the subtleties of it. Tension is the shoulders rising when you're scared, or the thighs squeezing when you're thinking really hard. It is muscle contractions that originate from our mental or emotional state. Tension is usually chronic, which means we're doing it all the time without noticing. The next time you are stressed, perhaps even right now, you might notice this. Eyes squinting, jaw clenched, shoulders raising, thighs squeezing or pulling apart, lifting the legs, squeezing your tummy. Chronic tension leads to tightness. If a muscle is constantly contracted, it's constantly shortened. These shortened muscles become hard like glue. So remember, every time you create tension in your body, you're practicing this, you're performing repetitions, and establishing your tightness further and further. You can imagine that if you've been practicing a certain pattern of tension for a long time, say 20 or 30 years, then you're probably pretty damn good at it, which really means you have a lot of tightness. So to conclude, what actually leads to tightness? It is the constant repetitions that we perform. It is the learning of tightness. In our next video, we're gonna go deeper into why you have tension, the nervous system, and why this is one of the biggest factors of why you are tight.